Hi, this is Tom Schoenbarger with Power Flight. Today we're going to describe how to replace the motor on a wet dry vac. And typical causes of damage to wet dry vacs usually include not using the correct filter. Correct filter such as your dry filter, which is your pleated filter for dry pickup, and then your wet filter, which is your cloth filter that you use primarily for any wet substance, stripped wax, water, things of that nature. So let's, with all that being said, let's get started and see what we got in front of us. Tools you will need: a fine flathead screwdriver, a drill with a number 2 Phillips bit, Torx set at 12. After you've removed the head unit off of the base of your machine, you'll have a series of screws at the top. There will be 6, and then there will be 8 at the bottom perimeter. We'll start with the top. When you open the top, you'll want to remove your ground wire from your wire connector plug. That's where your fine flathead screwdriver will come into play. To the appropriate slot, back out the screw and pull your wire loose. You're all set. Now you can take the remaining screws from the base perimeter and expose the motor. Keep in mind, as you start to separate your each individual part, you have a series of arrows here that line up. You'll want to make sure that those arrows are correctly lined up when you reassemble, so they make it a little easier as you go back together. To remove the middle section, you're going to unhook from your terminal spades your yellow and black wire off the back side of your switch. Everything is then ready to separate. Set your top down, and now your motor is exposed. You have 4 short screws that keep your motor intact, and you have 3 screws and a center screw to take the base seal off. Lift the base seal up over, exposing the motor. The motor should then pull out freely and is ready to replace. Keep in mind, if you have damage that includes stripped wax, you have foam pieces that go around the perimeter of your motor, and you'll want to replace those as well. We'll take our new motor, we will take the bottom seal from the existing motor, clean it up, rinse it off, wipe it off, whatever is required, reapply it to the base of your new motor, and then you're going to seat your new motor back into the cup that you pulled. There are four holes around the perimeter of your motor. If you look inside the frame of that, you'll see four lines that lead to each hole. That is going to line you up with the holes on your plate once you reapply it. Pull your wires through. Plate will sit down, and then you will spin your motor to line the holes up. Keep in mind, you have your arrow for your two space seats that need to line up as well on the black plastic parts. Spin your motor in the correct position, and then reattach your screws. Be sure and lock down your center screw in the middle of your hub and your existing three screws around the seated base. Now that your motor's in place, you're ready to reapply the two top heads. You will start with your yellow wire goes to the existing tab on the back side of the white wire, and of course black goes to the black. Simply push those into place. Line your arrow up. Now before you do that, you'll want to put your ground wire through the top center hole where your wire travel is. And then line your arrows up to secure everything back down. Your long screws, there should be eight of those. They go around the large perimeter. Attach your ground wire to the terminal block using your fine flathead screwdriver. Push it into the correct position and tighten it down. And that's it. You're all set. Use whichever filter you need for whatever job you're doing, and you should be ready to go. Those are the easy steps that are required to replace the motor in your wet dry vac. We hope that it's been helpful to you. If you need any further assistance, please call us at our 1-800 number or look us up online anytime. Thank you.